look at some more MCQs. In the estimation of Dumas method, 1.18 grams of an organic compound give 224 ml of nitrogen at LTP. The percentage of nitrogen in that compound is, so they are saying, particularly they are saying Dumas method. Dumas method means you have to find out the formula. So remember the formula, percentage of nitrogen in Dumas method. Percentage of nitrogen is equal to 28 by 22,400 into volume of nitrogen at STP by weight of organic compound into 100. Percentage of nitrogen in Jindal's method is equal to 1.4 into normal P into volume of H2SO4 solution by weight of organic compound. So now substitute the values 1.4 into normal P. What is the normal P? N by 5. N by 5 means 1 by 5. That is 0.2 volume of the solution 29 ml by weight of organic compound 0.5. So by simplifying this thing, you will get a percentage of nitrogen in Jindal's. In Dumas method, nitrogen in organic compound is estimated in the form of N2 gas. In Jindal's method, nitrogen is estimated in the form of ammonia. In Jindal's method, nitrogen is estimated in the form of ammonia. In Dumas method, nitrogen is estimated in the form of nitrogen. Next. 29.5 milligrams of an organic compound. So weight of organic compound is given 29.5 milligrams. This is good knowledge. So this final chapter is Tarpanyam. So three ways of interpretation will give you Tarpanyam. Next, most stable carbocation. Most stable carbocation. So you know the carbocation is something like benzene, alkyl, tertiary, secondary, primary method. So look at the carbon. So you can find the one is benzene, alkyl, tertiary, secondary, primary, methyl. Carbocations are stabilized by electron donating groups. Carbocations are stabilized by electron donating groups. Based on the one given a problem, which one is the most stable carbocation? The given different options. These are the different types of carbocations. Now they are asked which one is more stable. So this is primary, which is secondary. And this one is bonded with this carbocation part is bonded with two electron donating groups. Two electron donating group means it is more stable when compared with this. So more stable carbocation is this one. This is when I am most unstable. Some examples are given and they are asking what kind of reactions are present. Now let's see. Here bromine is substituted by OH. Sorry. Here bromine and hydrogen are eliminated. Bromine and hydrogen are eliminated. So this is the elimination reaction. So what kind of elimination? A hydrogen and a bromine is eliminated. So it is a dehydrohalogenation reaction. It is a dehydrohalogenation reaction. is a dehydroalkylation. Now look at this one. Here bromine is there, here OH is there. What happened? Bromine is substituted by OH. So it is a nucleophilic substitution. And never mind, no development. No bromines, two bromines are added. Means it is an addition reaction. So this is dehydroalkylation. This is nucleophilic substitution. This is addition. Okay? Dehydroalkylation, nucleophilic substitution, this is addition. So these are the different reactions. The order of decreasing reactivity towards an electrophilic reagent for the following ways. So they are asking the order of decreasing electrophilic reactivity, electrophilic substitution reactivity of the following things. Given some compounds. From those compounds, we are asking which one easily undergoes electrophilic substitution and write down them in an order. So, compounds are benzene. Second one is toluene. Third one is chlorobenzene. Fourth one is phenol. So these are the four compounds. Now they are asking which one easily undergoes electrophilic substitutions. So look at the structure. So due to the electron donation nature of this oxygen, it increases the electron density at outer position and para position. And to chlorobenzene. Here also three electron pairs are there due to resonance effect. It also increases electron density at dark position and para position. Up to this one, toluene. You know, methyl group is an electron donating group. Methyl is an electron donating group. Hence electron density increases at after position and para position. After para position. So this is simple benzene. Now you have to find out in which thing this electrophilic substitution reactions are easily occurs. In which thing electrophilic substitution reactions are easily occurs. That is the question they are asking us. In among these four things, in which one electrophilic substitution reactions are easily occurring? That is the question they are asking. First, look at this one. Phenol. In case of phenoxide ion, more electron density is present within small oxygen atom. Hence, it radiates. gave up on having a gene only. It's simply electron donating books, no electron withdrawing book, he said. So after four, in which thing easily electrophilic substitution takes place in poly. After that, we have bromine. After that, we have the benzene. So this is the order of electrophilic substitution reactions in different kinds of compounds. 9, yeah. C3, H9. From this formula, they are asking how many number of structural isomers are possible. So, trying to draw the isomers for this carbon. 3 carbons are there, 9 hydrogens are there. This is another isomer. So, how many isomers are formed again? 4 isomers are there. 4 structural isomers are possible with this formula C3, H9, N. With this formula, you get 4 isomers. Thanks for calling.